Next, we look for the special address of Professor Kannan M. Moudgalya, Irash and Megru Mehta Advanced Education Technology, Chair Professor, IIT Bombay.
Thank you. Honorable AICT Chairman, Professor Sasrabude, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Anna University, Professor Surappa, other dignitaries, friends, students, happy to share some of my thoughts on this important occasion. I will not repeat what other people have already said. Everybody knows about COVID, but I will not talk about it. Our role in this hackathon is through token tutorial project and also through the Indian Culture Project, which is funded by Ministry of Culture. What we did was we informed the 15,000 students who had done well in our online courses, online test rather, and invited them to participate. Because one of the problems was, how do we get the people, how do we get the students, how do we inform the students, and how to motivate good students to contribute? Because if we don't get enough people participating, then all our work will be wasted. So thanks to all the team's effort and our own effort in a small way, we are able to get a good number of people to participate. And I'm pretty sure that we will get a good number of solutions. We developed an app for the Indian Culture Portal through the NVLI project. Some staff members from there are participating as experts. It turns out that our main product, namely the spoken tutorial, was possibly created keeping this COVID in mind. Self-learning, so that the students could learn by themselves, even if teachers are not there, even if they don't go to schools and colleges. They are dubbed into all 22 languages, and they can also be used offline. The offline usage is extremely important, because the other day, somebody wrote to me from Jammu saying that they had only 2G connection, whether they could access it. And so we told them, because our method is created for self-learning, people could download spoken tutorials even through a slow connection and then use them. Thanks to Professor Sasrabude, thanks to AICT TAG, now spoken tutorials are also on the SWAYAM portal, which means that they can be used against the MOOCs quota of 15%. Possibly because of all these things, the number of page views in our portal have gone up considerably. We are hitting 2.5 lakh page views a day now. About a year ago, year and a half ago, we went for paid certification process as suggested by MHRD. NMEICT asked me, what is the guarantee that our tutorials are really useful? If they are really useful, will people pay a little bit? NMEICT challenged me, can you raise some funds from users? So we came up with a very nominal sum of 25,000 rupees per college per year. That will allow any number of students from that college to appear in any number of tests, and if they pass the test, they will get the certificate. So of course, our tutorials continue to be available for free. Doesn't have to pay, one doesn't have to register, one doesn't have to log in, but only for online test we came up with a proposal, and NMEICT encouraged us to go for that. I'm happy to say that more than 1,000 colleges have signed up for that. And interestingly, the completion rate has gone up 3 times. When it was free, only 13-14% of the people, students, used to take the online test. Now that it has become, there is a small payment, every college is encouraging their students to participate. In fact, 50% of the students who undergo our training take this test. So apparently, there is every college has some funds reserved for faculty development program. From that, this money can be easily assigned. And I would encourage, in fact, I would request Professor Surappa to inform the Anna University colleges to encourage them to participate and benefit. In fact, there are some colleges in Hyderabad in which they said that the students got the certificate for about 10, 15 rupees per student. So if because of that, the students end up studying and doing well, then why not encourage them? One thing I want to point out, because I have a large number of tutorials in Tamil, and Anna University is in Tamil Nadu. Anna University can help a large number of schools to come use the Tamil dubbing. Because I myself studied in a Tamil medium school, in a government school. So we didn't have many resources. But we have technology now. If only Anna University departments and constituent colleges can be encouraged to use spoken tutorials and go to schools and make this available through NSS program or various other things, it will be extremely good. I'm happy that we are able to do this hackathon. Anna University is doing this hackathon. And people who do well in the hackathon will be able to get job easily. Unfortunately, our curriculum has become more of memorization. And given that background, all these activities, such as writing their own code, writing their own programs that work, and doing some things by themselves, are extremely important, and I'm happy that Anna University is encouraging that. I mentioned Tamil dubbing. We, of course, have been dubbing our tutorials in all 22 languages, including Sanskrit, for example, because Sanskrit happens to be one of our 22 languages. We have large number of tutorials dubbed in Tamil, Hindi, Gujarati, Marathi, Bengali, Assamese, Punjabi, and so on and so forth. I can go on telling. So all our languages. So I request, in fact, Professor Sastrabudde told me that he will, as soon as our language dub tutorials come on Swayam portal, he said that he'll be happy to write to UGC also to tell them to bring to the attention of people in those who might be doing BA, BSc, BCom. They also need IT. They can also write good code. They can also develop nice portals and so on and so forth. So why not bring it to their attention? So we have 1,000 tutorials on 75 topics. In fact, I propose to work with Mr. Jeeva in the near future and develop some more useful tutorials for job seekers and entrepreneurs and make them available free of cost, and of course dub them in all languages and give them. I would like to conclude my brief speech with a quote from Thirukkural. So this is the we all believe that Thiruvalluvar, Saint Thiruvalluvar, lived more than 2000 years ago, and his major contribution is to bring Vedas in a form that ordinary people can understand, because otherwise these were available only to well-learned, highly learned people. But how about common people? Why don't we make this available to them also? So in that sense, Thirukkural is an amazing collection. In fact, we call Thiruvalluvar Deva Pulavar, that is Saint Muni, who brought these important thoughts to the level of ordinary people. Ivan mudikkum enroindhu adanai avan kan vidal. So this is the quote told to the kings. So we have, for example, vice chancellor. In Tamil we say tunai vendar. Vendar means king. So this is an advice to the kings. So in this case, Professor Sastrabudde and Professor Surappa. இதனை இதனால் இவன் முடிக்கும் என்றாய்ந்து அதனை அவன் கண் விடல். ப்ளீஸ் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட், திஸ் வாட் திருவள்ளுவர் சேஸ், ப்ளீஸ் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் ஹூ வில் டூ வாட் with what instrument. The moment you find out, assign the job to them and give them complete freedom. Let them do the work and they will deliver. So this is a thought. Now we are talking about independence, decentralization, and so on and so forth. So this was conveyed to us, advised to us by Thiruvalluvar more than 2000 years ago. And it is because of such important decisions, freedom given by the Honorable Vice Chancellor, Honorable AACT Chairman, we are able to achieve a lot of things. I wish that this will continue. And I wish that we will work under their guidance and do many more things and make us a developed country as told to us by our Honorable President, Dr. Abdul Kalam, who encouraged us, who made us long for living in a developed country. I think let's not stop with just addressing this COVID problem. Let's march ahead and let us make India a developed country. So with this, I would like to congratulate all the students for having joined this hackathon. I wish them all the best. I wish them all the success. I'm sure that with a lot of effort, because now they cannot go anywhere. All of you are at home. Please don't turn on the TV. Please work 24 hours if possible. Work hard and create amazing apps. These will be used in every state. Every state will use them. They will give you jobs. You can start your own company. Jiva will tell you how to do that and so on. So I would like to conclude my talk. Thanks for giving me this opportunity. Goodbye and Jai Hind.